What is going on? We're out here in the wild inside, and we've got a bunch of beautiful species that I think needs to be observed. So let me take you with me. Over there, we got the Kodak Super 8 film camera, motion picture of course. We got the Canon AE-1 film camera, and then the Fujifilm point and shoot film camera. Is film dead? No idea. I'm still gonna shoot it as long as it's affordable and people still process it. And then here at the back end, we got the Canon T3i, the OG DSLR. And then right beside it, we got the Sony NEX5, the camera that got me on my way to photography and filmmaking. And then here at the end, we got the Fujifilm X-T20. It's a film camera. Oh, no, just kidding. It's electronic. It's got the EVF. And I'm not here to talk about gear. No. I'm here to give a silly little update about this YouTube channel out in the wild and where it's headed this month in May, next month in June, and what's to follow in July. And the reason why I'm talking about this topic is because this video wasn't going to be this video. It was going to be a video where I would go out to a local park, shoot nature, shoot the birds, shoot the bees, shoot the lake, shoot the people coexisting in the natural landscape. But the problem is, I was going to cut it to some jazz music because it was going to be purely visual. It was going to be aesthetic, and I didn't want that. At some point, I started thinking, this doesn't feel right. And that's because it had no direction, no purpose, no story. But that's where it all stems from me. The visual creation stems from just having a good time capturing what I think is beautiful and cool and loving what I liked and hoping other people loved what I liked too. And the problem with that sort of mode of operation is that I think I've outgrown that. I think where I stand now is making videos that tell a story, that have a call to action above all. With this YouTube channel, it's centered around natural history and wildlife and giving access to those who might not think that the outdoors is approachable. And, you know, with that being said, there's a mission behind these videos that I make. I have a vision of where I want all of them to head towards. But that video lacked it. And I felt like I was going to be flexing my creative muscles and then sharing it, but I don't think that's the way to go. I think that if I want to share my love for the visual side of filmmaking, then why not just talk about the process itself and where all those images come from? Which are these accoutrements that I have laid out, these small little boxes that gather light. And I've been doing it for 10, 11, or 12 years since middle school, basically. And of course, I've acquired all of them throughout time. And, you know, it's important that I talk about this technical side because it's what gets me outside in the first place. It enhances my experience outside, it augments it, and it often dictates how I interact with nature. And, you know, some people might snide at the fact that I go outside and I interact via technology, and some might snide at the fact that people need their phones when they go out in nature, even though they're trying to unplug. It doesn't matter. What really matters is people are getting outside, and I hope they start fostering that closer relationship with nature, so, you know, we protect it a little more. Because how else are people going to want to protect something if they don't know it? If they don't have a reason to? So, that being said, in June, I'm going to be largely making videos that talk about the brand that I shoot with, which is, of course, Fujifilm. And I'm not at all endorsing it. I'm not being paid. I would recommend the brand because it's made making images far more easier for me. But I'm doing it above all for a timely matter. Fujifilm is coming out with a conference on May 31st, which should be tomorrow. And it's going to be called the Fujifilm X Summit. They're going to be announcing their newest camera called the Fujifilm X-H2S. And it'll basically be the introduction to a whole new line of cameras, sensors, and processes for Fujifilm. And as someone that's invested money into that brand, I want to make sure that whatever developments they make aren't going to be bad. I don't think they've really made anything bad in general. Maybe they can improve on the video quality when it comes to their lens performance. But overall, they're a pretty solid company. And what I really want to do is contribute to the growth of their attention to wildlife, nature, and just outdoor shooters. Because I feel like that has kind of flown under the radar. Maybe there's more love for traveling, but I think the outdoors and nature subjects need a little bit more attention, Fujifilm. With those videos, it'll give more value to the brand in terms of the experience of shooting with their cameras and also the experience of their cameras and the kind of technology that they have inside of them. I do want to bring it back to nature. It's got to come back to nature. And it's going to be about camping, largely. But I will be traveling in the month of July, so I'm not entirely sure if those videos will be out in July. I don't have these videos lined up where I'm going to be able to upload them on a specific date. I usually just film the videos and then I upload them shortly thereafter. I don't have the capacity to be able to shoot a ton of videos and then line them up, unfortunately. Not right now, at least. So that being said, it might come in July, and it might very well come in August, depending on how my hiatus goes. I think the only thing I want to say lastly is that this video, I'm here at my house just talking to a camera. I hope that whoever's been watching so far and anyone new enjoys this little fireside chat, because really this channel is supposed to be about the outdoors, but I do say with the Jona gaze, with my gaze, and I think it's important to address me being in front of the camera. I don't really want to be in front of the camera. I do it because I know that some people might see me out in the wild and think, huh, that guy looks like me, they act like me, they know as much as me, I can get outside too. Because I feel like the outdoors has met some inhibitions in terms of its approachability and its accessibility. Some people might think, oh, it's reserved for people that know about trees, plants, birds, bees. And then some people might think, I don't have enough money. I don't have enough affluence to get out there. But I'm here to say, no, no, no. Nature is for everyone. And I think that we should all be leading with that sort of mindset, because how else are we supposed to grow? How else is nature supposed to grow if we don't have that sort of growth mindset? I think I need to end the video there. Take care until the next one. I hope to see you out in the wild.